More than 1,000 years ago, a bold Viking, Thorgil Skafi, in the service of the King of Norway, landed on these English shores and set up a fort called Skardiborg. Here he established a Norwegian settlement, but this Viking stronghold was burnt to the ground 100 years later, and for 40 years lay fallow until the arrival of the Norman barons. Thorgil Skafi's name lives on in the tales of the Norsemen, the Icelandic sagas, and in the name of Skardiborg, or, as it is known today, Scarborough. Following the turbulent centuries between the conquering William of Normandy and the reforming Puritan Cromwell, mineral springs were discovered at Scarborough in the 17th century, and the town became popular as a spa. The gentry made their periodic visits here to imbibe the spa waters, and Sheridan wrote a play about the then fashionable trip to Scarborough. It was a bathless age, but in spite of strong prejudice against any form of bathing, a resident of Scarborough, a Dr. Whitty, ardently advocated the virtues of sea bathing. A new fashion arose among the gentry. In cobble boats they took to the sea, where, a little way out from the shore, they would bathe naked. The success of sea bathing established Scarborough as the first seaside resort in Britain. Scarborough town offers all the typically English seaside attractions and more. Coming as a surprise to many new visitors to the resort is Scarborough's great natural beauty. That it is sometimes called Queen of the Yorkshire Coast seems well deserved. Off-season, Scarborough rates as one of the top conference centres in Britain. Today, the boundaries of Scarborough town have been widened to take in 40 miles of coastline, including the sister resorts of Filey and Whitby, and countless acres of forest, moorland and wold. All this is Greater Scarborough. At the end of the Civil Wars, Scarborough, garrison town and port, was the last royalist stronghold on this coast to surrender to Cromwell's armies. The castle died, but the port is still very much alive. Smart yachts, sturdy fishing boats, and modern cargo vessels of up to 1,000 tons ply in and out of the two tidal harbours. Scarborough town has spread itself around two magnificent bays, the South Bay and the North Bay. The North Bay, virtually bingo-less and quieter, has its own attractions. The zoo, open-air theatre, bathing pools, and Peace Home Park, and its own sandy beach. But for 1 week, every June, Scarborough's character takes on a continental flavour. Majorettes from Holland parade the streets. Champion trampolinists from Switzerland thrill onlookers with their skill. An unusual sound echoes through Scarborough, almost reminiscent of those far-off Viking days, a Swiss alpine horn. Elsewhere, a Romanian folk group captures a fascinated audience. Scarborough's Eurofair week is in full swing, but last-minute preparations for the grand carnival procession are still going on. Uniți flori în băsmăluțe, că și eu ți-am fost drăguțe, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. Ține flori în dreapta ta și cu stânga mai juca, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. Joacă-mă, bădiță ghine, cum se joacă-n sat la mine, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. Stânga, dreapta, doi și doi, și înainte și înapoi, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. Mai bădiță, lasă, lasă, amândoi mergea spre casă, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. Mai ținut în frig la foarte și nu mai pupat odată, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. Nu știu, ești așa tăcut, oricând greu ca la început, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. Spune, bădiță, ți-i greu, că fac începutul eu, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. Nu știu, ești așa tăcut, oricând greu ca la început, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. Spune, bădiță, ți-i greu, că fac începutul eu, mai bădiță tare, dragne fost. It is the eve of the Grand Carnival procession. A fairy tale atmosphere surrounds this carnival float. Its theme is taken from the fantasy by Ian Fleming about an extraordinary motor car called Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. Work goes on late into the evening, but not in vain. For tomorrow, this float will take first prize as best entry in the show. Excitement is in the air as the numerous entrants in the grand carnival show prepare to present their colourful floats, costumes and cheerful faces to an expectant town. And so at 3:30 in the afternoon, the carnival procession is about to move off. Up to 100,000 people will watch, clap and cheer it on its 3-mile route. Just 1 week. Scarborough's more permanent attractions can be enjoyed between May and early autumn. Swimming is not confined to the sea. This glorious North Bay pool is heated and ozonized, while another pool in the South Bay contains sun-heated seawater. Independent of weather is a large indoor swimming pool which operates all the year round. And of course, a number of hotels have their own private swimming pools. Not a bad choice for a resort with a natural population of about 43,000 inhabitants.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Scarborough Zoo and Marine Land.
A moderate entrance charge admits parents and children to a host of special shows at Scarborough Zoo and Marine Land. The dolphin show is always a great hit with holidaymakers.
Give her a cheeky push him out. Oh. Oh, you're kidding. Come on, that's really terrible, boys and girls. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Right, wait a minute. Come in. Do you enjoy that? Do you enjoy that?
Although the dolphins, Flipper and Genki, are the main attractions of this large pleasure park, in an adjacent 1,000-seat stadium, a troupe of performing parrots from California put on an exhibition of rare skills.
Head down, Steve, across the table.
Other shows feature chimpanzees and parading penguins, and of course, the conventional caged animals invite one's attention. Peace Home Park is one of Scarborough's beautiful gardens, a place for enjoying peaceful and leisurely activities sheltered from the sea breezes. To enhance the natural beauty of the town, there are more than 350 acres of parks and gardens, such as Holberg Gardens and the popular Italian Gardens.
Thank you.
Sea breezes and flowers don't easily mix, so it said. But George Beeforth disproved it 100 years ago when he retired from London to grow roses in Scarborough. His successors have planted acres and acres of flowers and made them grow along the coastal strip within sight and sound of the sea. Back to Peace Home Park, where the peace and quiet is about to be broken. The boating lake is transformed into a stage for a famous naval battle. Models of merchant ships and warships, submarines and aircraft, and an enemy-held port are involved in a story filled with action and enacted with amazing realism. Seekers of action and adventure usually find their way to Scarborough's mere. Treasure hunters join the Hispaniola on a voyage to Treasure Island. This model of the Hispaniola is an exact quarter-scale replica of a merchantman of the period in which Robert Louis Stevenson set his story. There are, of course, those who prefer to paddle their own canoes around the islands. We'll be right back. junior water ski champion gives a demonstration for the benefit of those who are just taking to their water skis. But this school, also at the Mere, has taught hundreds of people of all ages the exciting and exhilarating art of skiing on water. The countryside around Scarborough Town has several 18th and 19th century houses and inns which have been modernised and converted into beautiful country hotels. This one, at Hackness, was once occupied by the family of Lord Derwent and is popular not only with anglers but also with those seeking restful days in luxury.
Good morning.
How are you?
Thank you.
Morning, how are you? This is usual, please. And need it.
Straight up to the
gate. Lovely day.
Straight up. Oh, well, you
passed
down here.
Was he in between?
No, no, he got there. And I just said to Jayne, I said it was
champagne. Cheers. Good
health. Cheers, Jayne.
It was the first time
I asked. Oh, needed that. More than anything.
Anybody else down today?
No, there's no one else down. Beautiful morning.
For holidays in a contrasting style, there are, in the southern part of Greater Scarborough, caravan and holiday camps. This camp offers holiday motels, bungalows, caravans and chalets, together with an impressive range of free entertainment. On the coast of this southern part of Greater Scarborough lies the friendly holiday town of Filey. Gaily coloured cobble boats decorate the pathway to the north side of the beach. Peculiar to the Yorkshire coast, the cobble boat has its origins in the Viking longships. Tractors haul the boats across the sand and onto the cobble landing. The wide yet sheltered bay is extremely popular with small boat sailors, and regular competitions are a feature of the town. But Filey's glory is its golden beach, stretching literally for miles. Occasionally used for motor racing, it is best enjoyed in other ways. Let's take a ride.
By the firelight, I see her face before my eyes, Lady Rose, ah, Lady Rose, oh Lady, my Rose, my Lady Rose. Lasting memories of the moment, of the time spent, of the days when Lady Rose. Shadows to the bright lights, from the dark nights to the sunrise, Lady Rose, ah, Lady Rose, oh Lady, my Rose, my Lady Rose.
Some of the most beautiful fishing towns and villages in Yorkshire are to be found in the northern part of Greater Scarborough's coastline. Picturesque fishing town of Staithes, the characteristic Staithes bonnet is still worn by the older women. It is from a little grocer's shop in this town that James Cook, a poor apprentice, ran away to the neighbouring fishing port of Whitby to sail the seas and to become one of the greatest seamen of all time. Whitby, these gigantic jawbones stand as a reminder of this town's great days of whaling. Another Whitby seaman, William Scoresby's, pioneer of whaling, reached the farthest north of his day and is said to have captured more whales than any other man. It is he who introduced the lookout at a ship's masthead, known as the Crow's Nest. Fine Whitby ships sailed by Captain Cook on his voyages of discovery have gone. The brave captains and the ships they sailed to the Greenland whaling ground have also become a part of Whitby's proud past. But the natural harbour formed by the estuary of the River Esk, Yorkshire's only salmon river, is still busy with yachts, fishing boats and cargo fleets. Time has not spoilt Whitby. It has developed into a natural resort, the second largest on the greater Scarborough coast. Many families are attracted here during the long months of summer. Cliff overlooking the town and harbour of Whitby stand the ruins of the ancient abbey of St Hilda. It was here that English literature was born, with the writing by Caedmon of his Song of Creation. Robin Hood's Bay is a quaint fishing village, which rumour has it was once the secret landing place of Robin Hood. In the past it had strong associations with smuggling. Today it is a haven for artists. Feet above sea level is the highest point along the Scarborough coast. The Romans had a signal station here similar to those at Firely and Castle Hill Scarborough. Their purpose was to give warning of Saxon and other sea raiders who harassed the coast in the late 4th century. Today, this ancient site is occupied by an 18th century mansion converted into a luxury hotel. Ravenscar, Whitby, Firely, Runswick, Wickham, Hunmanby. All names within the area reflecting Scandinavian origins. Another is Haven Wyke, where access to the sea is difficult, but for lovers of solitude, bays like this are rewarding. Scarborough is but 6 miles away. Behind the northern part of this glorious coast, the hinterland of Greater Scarborough stretches inland up the 20-mile-long valley of the Esk to the heights of Commondale and Westerdale. Almost half of the North York Moors National Park is contained within the Greater Scarborough area. This is true holiday country. Noise and laughter when the mood demands it, peace and relaxation when the mind seeks it. But above all, beauty in abundance. Fair Scarborough, Scarborough Fair. Approach Scarborough town, the moorland gives way to pastoral scenery, forest, and the grass-clad slopes of the Yorkshire Wolds. A sublime area unspoilt by factory or motorway. A relic of the old England.
Here we are, Gary. There's your autograph. Thank you very much. Put your neck up there, because...
With the evening approaching, the big names in the spectacular Scarborough shows begin to arrive at the theatres. Freddie Davis is greeted by autograph hunters.
Follow my hat. Come here. Come here.
Come here and stand there with you.
Why not? No wonder I'm sick up to here. Good to do the show now. See you in Scarborough.
As the sun sinks lower in the sky, Scarborough prepares to enter yet another phase.
You're on in 2 minutes.
The countryside is beautiful around here. This is my first summer season, and I thought perhaps it might be a little bit sort of plastic and everywhere would be fish and chips, and I might get a bit bored after the first few days. But it's not true, because there's some super places to drive out and see, and I've opened lots of garden things. I've really enjoyed it. I think it's one of the loveliest seaside resorts in England. It must be.
Thank you.
Sunday morning, just my friend and me. The sun and the seabird calling, longing to be free.
The drums went bang and the trumpets blew, and we marched right down into the town. And